Cloud Gurus. I'm... Hold on a sec. Oh, wow. This is what it's like up here. Hi, Cloud Gurus. I'm Jess Alvarez, and joining me today is Justin Wheeler. He might be recognizable from Discord.
Hi, my name is Justin Wheeler. I'm currently working as a senior software developer consultant at Bravo LT. Before that, I was working as a cloud architect, and I'm also an AWS community builder.
So today, Justin and I were able to attend Werner's keynote. We're going to go ahead and talk about some of those topics. What did you find interesting?
One of the most interesting aspects of the keynote for me was that AWS continued to expand their global network. He announced 30 new local zones across 5 continents, and also a new region in Antarctica. What did you like from the keynote?
I was super excited about the announcement of Cloud WAN, the wide area network. I think that is going to change the way our globalized services, specifically like VPC, is used across different use cases. I think it opens up a lot of doors for a lot of customers, so that's really great.
I definitely think that AWS will give us some sort of configuration options there, like they have in the past. I would speculate maybe something like a WAN flow logs or even some security mechanisms to control that traffic flow. As a developer, I was personally interested in the new SDKs that were announced for Kotlin, Rust, and Swift.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I know Rust is one specifically that lots of people have been asking for forever. It was really cool to see them announce it. I was really excited about the CDK V2 that they announced. That was really cool. And I loved how they brought Liberty Mutual in to talk about specifically how they turned 1,500 lines of CloudFormation template into a 14-line CDK template. And that is absolutely incredible. It cut me so deep. It's right here, silent tear. It's a beautiful world we live in.
Yeah, it's just mind blowing. Having so much experience with CloudFormation, I definitely know the struggles there. And CDK is definitely solving them.
I was also super excited about the announcement of Amplify Studio. It was really cool that we got to see an actual walkthrough of it.
With Amplify Studio, I'm starting to notice a no-code trend coming from AWS with the announcement of Honeycode last year and the announcement of SageMaker Canvas earlier in the week. Wasn't expecting a demo on the keynote. I thought that was really interesting.
The big thing for me today, was super exciting, was the announcement of the new pillar, sustainability. I think it's really incredible that AWS is extending out a new responsibility to the customer for sustainability. It's awesome. What do you think about that?
Sustainability is so important for everyone, not just for AWS, right? And with the carbon footprinting tool, now customers can actually monitor their carbon usage and kind of be held accountable for that.
Absolutely. One world, guys. Little blue dot.
I think we're almost at 300 plus services now. How can people stay current? Because it's kind of overwhelming at some points.
Oh, definitely. First and foremost, number one, I would say AWS this week, right, guys? AWS just announced the repost, right? So that's a forum for the community. So you post your questions, get answers from other people in the community, which is really helpful, especially when you get stuck on those projects that you just can't find the answer on Google. And that's our Thursday recap, gurus. Thank you for watching, but stay tuned for a special episode of AWS This Week with Ryan and Faye. Awesome. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. Cheese.